So, welcome everybody. My name is Paweł Śniecikowski. I work for Samsung R&D Poland. And today I would like to tell you a little bit about something which is below application level. So, in the previous presentation... It's working? Okay. In the previous presentation, you saw some how to protect at the application layer. I would like to tell you a little bit about platform. So, what's below the applications. And I'm working with in mobile B2B, and basically we are at Samsung trying to provide security of our platform and several security tools to our customers, mostly to B2B customers, to make mobile device and corporate data, corporate applications secure and in the company. Let me start from a quick introduction, some context. So today, I'm not sure if you knew, but around 70% today of worldwide mobile worldwide population is using mobile devices. So more than 5 billion, we have more than 5 billion unique mobile users, and it's growing around 4-5% per year. So it's still growing. And if we look on the traffic, coming from mobile devices, so more than half of the traffic now comes from mobile devices. And if we look how we use these mobile devices, we will find out that we spend seven times longer using mobile applications comparing to just browsing the web. So we started to use our phones for special purposes, like emails, like some company applications, business applications, of course, social media as well. So we are using these devices more and more on some special purposes. And if we look on B2B market today, I think that almost all of us are using emails, but our companies are putting more and more applications to our mobile phones. So today, in today's market, everyone wants to have quick information, wants to have quick reaction. So we need tools for that. And of course, we need security for that. So let's talk about this security, but before we start talking about security and what tools we have, I would like to tell you that mobile security is not the only thing we have to think about. So there are a few other challenges which we have to think. And as you can imagine, mobile device is a little bit different from laptop. It's smaller, and it makes a huge difference in terms of security. So I can leave this device in a taxi, in a restaurant, in anywhere actually. Here after the conference, I can just in the hall, I can leave it. Someone can take it and try to do some bad things with my device. So with laptop, we basically leave our laptop in the office or at home, and it's a little bit more difficult to leave it, or that someone will steal this device from us. So we have to think about the security a little bit more when we are talking about mobile devices. But as I said, first, security of the corporate data is the most important, but that's not the only thing. So there's another thing which we have to provide when we are designing a platform, mobile platform for business, it's an efficient mobile device management. So the administrator, if he push here some applications, business applications, would like to control these applications, would like to control this device, apply some policies, and he must react for security incidents. So once I lose this device, I call the IT admin from another device, and I'm telling that I lost the device. He must have tools to make a quick reaction, block it, wipe it, whatever. And another thing which we cannot forget about it is the privacy of a user. Again, we carry this device all the time with us, so probably we don't want the IT admin to know our location all the time, to know what applications we are using, what are our activities. All the time. So it's privacy of user is becoming more and more important when we are talking even about business usage, not only, of course, consumer usage. And of course, another thing which is specific to mobile devices is user interface. So it's user interface, it's again a little bit different than a laptop user interface. So we would like to control it with one finger. It must be quick, it must be user-friendly. So we cannot have tools which are overloaded with some we have to input some information with keyboard, like we can do it easily on a PC. So probably you know more challenges or more requirements in your companies, but when we took all of this into the consideration, we have to think about the security from a little bit different perspective. So what can we do? I took from UK National Cybersecurity Center some guidelines, some 12 security principles. It's not related strictly to mobile devices, but it's to end user devices, but it's kind of universal. And I would like to give you a few examples what can we do to fulfill these requirements, to be compliant with these 12 security principles. Some of them are already mentioned, like, of course, data in transit protection. It's universal, not only for mobile device, but for every device. Data at rest protection, it's extremely important for mobile device. Authentication, secure booting, so keeping the booting process, so firmware loading secure. Platform integrity and application sandboxing, so the topic which was a little bit described in the previous presentation, application whitelisting, few others, and at the end, incident response, very important from mobile device perspective. So I would like to give you some examples, what can we do, what we do at Samsung, what tools we provide, what project we have with our customers to fulfill these requirements. First of all, secure platform. We invested a lot, and also Google and Android. Google invested a lot into Android last years to provide security. So basically, we treat security as a kind of defense system. So we started from hardware. So I will not cover in details all of these things, but basically, the most important here is that we started from hardware. So our hardware has a trust zone technology, so the secure area is separated from the normal area of the chip. It's on the chip level. We also have some warranty fuse, which is hardware fuse. So if Nox platform will discover some attack, I will tell you in next slides what's the attack, the fuse will be burned. So it's only one time burning, and it can't be reversed back. So then the platform will be switched off. We have some cryptographic keys stored in the hardware generated during production of the device and unique for the device. So even, and these cryptographic keys are later used for derive other keys which are used for encrypting the data. We of course have several other software layers above that. We monitor the kernel, key components of kernel. We have some SE security enhancement for Android, which are basically doing the firewall between applications. And then on top of that, we have some tools which I will show you. Of course, we try to build trust and we follow standards. So we make common criteria certification, FIPS certification for some cryptographic components, and also we are running through certification and approvals from various countries. Security of the corporate data. We just mentioned that it's important, of course, and basically in many solutions, it's either you have the security, either you have the privacy. And in the one example, I would like to show you how we can maintain both things at the same time. So something which is called container. So container, I think Samsung was the first one, or probably the first one who started this idea. So we can divide the space of the mobile phone, of the smartphone, into two areas. So private area and corporate area. In the private area, the user can have whatever he wants to. So like Facebook, games, all kinds of applications. And the corporate area is fully under control of the IT admin. So first of all applications and data are encrypted. Then encryption is coming from these hardware keys. So the keys are not sitting in the software bar, but deep in the memory, in hardware memory, generated during production. It's separated from the private space, and the IT admin makes full control of this space. So push the applications, install the applications, make blacklist or whitelist of applications, apply some policies, password policies, firewall, URL blacklist, whatever. And also control interfaces, can configure Wi-Fi, disable Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, So this is under the full control, encrypted, and user needs to authenticate. For example, and this is a very nice concept because basically, if you apply such a strict policies for the whole device, and users will say, well, it's not convenient, we cannot work with it, I cannot check, I don't know, my Gmail, or I cannot check, go to some browser and check my private websites. But in this concept, in the private area, the user can do whatever he wants, and IT admin can apply much strict policies in this workspace area. As I said at the beginning, if the device discovers an attack, and an attack could be, for example, flashing the device with non-original Samsung software or rolling back the previous version of the operating system, which is also not forbidden in our devices, or disable some operating system security features, then the warranty hardware fuse will be burned and the Nox platform will be disabled, and also the workspace area will be disabled forever. We designed something which is called Common Criteria Compliant Mode. So as I mentioned in the first slide, we certify the devices according to Common Criteria certification, and we can, with one API, we provide one API, so IT admin through MDM console can use this API and switch the device into Common Criteria Compliant Mode, which means that, for example, only approved cryptographic algorithms can be used, some password policies will be applied, some download software mode will be disabled, and several other things will be configured. So the device automatically will switch to higher security mode. Of course, authentication, very important thing. IT admin has full control to for this workspace to decide what authentication methods will be used. So for example, pattern can be disabled, which is not very secure, but it also only password can stay. Also, it can be combined with biometrics. So like PIN with face or with fingerprint can be used. Also, it can be integrated with Active Directory. Biometric authentication, we could make a separate session about that, but just few things to be mentioned here. And it's universal to Android devices, not only Samsung, so because we get many questions about this. So basically, we store biometric templates. So this is not the real biometric, just the template. So even if you get out this template from the device, you cannot use it somewhere to authenticate. There is no possibility in Android system, and as well in Samsung, to get out this biometric template. So there's no API in Android to get out this template from the device. And in we use, of course, fingerprint, face recognition, and iris, which is the most secure. And in our devices, in Samsung devices, it's stored in the trust zone, so in this secure area, encrypted by these hardware keys. Also, we have some service we can enable, some FIDO server. FIDO is a fast identity online standard, so we can also enable this FIDO server verifying the transaction. We do some project like this with mostly with banking sector. Another thing which is important and kind of universal for end user devices is data in transit protection. So we can configure per application VPN, per container VPN, also per whole device VPN. We can also make several other things like on-demand VPN or on-premise VPN bypass. So once you connect to corporate Wi-Fi or corporate network, the VPN will be switched off. Another very important thing from the security point of view, so is storage of the credentials or storage of the cryptographic keys which are used for user authentication, for SSL, TLS sessions, or for VPN sessions. And we have two possibilities. One is so-called TIMA key store. So we have a special key store which is protected by, again, this trust zone and these hardware keys. So it's encrypted by hardware encryption, hardware keys encryption. Also we have something which is called embedded secure elements. So in most of our phones, we have special chip. The chip is designed for security, so it's the same chip like in banking cards or electronic passports. So this level of security, this chip has like several sensors, light sensor, high temperature sensor, high voltage sensor, so it's protected against hardware attacks, physical attacks, and also many software attacks, and it's certified according to common criteria and FIPS. So basically provide access to our customers to this chip, and you can store their cryptographic keys, credentials, and this basically is used for government companies or automotive companies. We have some projects with big automotive companies who would like to put a car access digital key to the car into the smartphone when this element is used in these projects. Also, very important thing which we provide should be used today by IT admin if you would like to have full control on the mobile device to get logs and some reports from the device if the device is still in the secure state or maybe something happened in the meantime. So first of all, we provide rich set of logs, so IT admin can monitor these logs. And very nice thing which we can provide is the so-called attestation report. So we provide an API, and from MDM console, IT admin can request such a report. And in this report, this provided the firmware versions, some cryptographic components versions, some security features are on and off, and this report is signed by the key sitting in our hardware, and also it can be combined with IMEI number. So basically the IT admin is 100% sure that the report came from exactly this device, and this report has not been manipulated during the transition. Audit logs, as I mentioned in the previous slide, IT admin can make a quick reaction if he can monitor the logs. If something suspicious happens or user disabled something security, some policy somehow, then he will get an alert and can make a quick reaction. So this is also a very powerful tool to manage, to keep the security of the device. So just wanted to tell you at the end of this part that I often hear that mobile devices are not secure, or Android is not secure. And basically, we can say today that it's not true. So the platform already, Samsung platform, but also Android platform, has lots of security features, lots of mechanisms which are by default enabled, by built-in. Lots of features which can be used are ready to be used. Just let's start to use it. One more thing I would like to say about the, of course, if someone would like to build some special purpose application, we provide a rich set of APIs, more than 1,000 APIs for the configuration and managing the device. One thing which is very important, not only for our devices, but for any device, whatever is Windows, iOS, or Android, it's the to have up-to-date firmware. In Android world, like for last 8 years, was 38 upgrades of the Android system. Much more, of course, security patches. In high-end devices, it's roughly per month, around month. And lower end devices per quarter, plus some bug fixes, plus some native application updates. And in Android now, the user has to approve this actually. So the user can disable these firmware upgrades, or at the end, of course, have to approve this, can cancel it. So at the end of the day, if you have like few hundred devices in your company, you can have devices with up-to-date software, devices with very old software not updated for 1 year or 2 years, for example, and devices which has been updated 1 year ago. So we have plenty of versions, and it's not good from the security point of view, and also not good from your applications point of view, because the applications can work different on different operating system versions. So we provide three very simple things how to manage that. So first of all, with enterprise FOTA service, IT admin can select the exact version of the operating system. Then he can select the exact time, the time slot when it will be installed, downloaded and installed, and can make forced updates. So end user will not be able to disable it or postpone it. Many attacks basically are, which I saw on mobile devices and during also many presentations, how to protect the devices, that many attacks were using very old vulnerabilities, very old security issues, which has been patched long time ago, like 1.5 years ago, and still many devices which are not upgraded can be on risk for such an attack. So it's very important to have up-to-date software on the device. Remote device configuration, we provide also some very nice tool for remote device configuration. So basically you can, from a mobile device, you can make a one-purpose device, you can put application and put the application so into the kiosk mode, so you can lock the device just to this one application. You can make many different advanced configurations. So you can remap hardware keys, you can disable hardware keys, you can change software and bootloaders, wallpapers. And then the best thing in that is that you can do it in the console. You can just assign serial numbers, and once end user employee gets a brand new device, open a box, connects to internet, every device will connect to the server. Every device connects to the server, and the server is checking if I have the device serial number on the list or not. If I have, the profile will be pushed. So we had a project with one big bank in Poland when they bought like 3,000 or 4,000 devices for end users, for their employees, for various branches in the whole country. So in the previous time, they had to manually do some pre-installation, pre-configuration, and then they just send these boxes to the employees, and everything was done automatically after connecting to internet. So they saved lots of time, and it's also important from the security point of view, as the end user has no possibility to bypass this process. It's done. Even if you make a factory reset, it's again, the profile is coming back. Of course, mobile device management, which we mentioned in the beginning, IT admin today must have a big possibility to manage the device, control it in real time. So we provide here more than 1,000 APIs to do that. But the most important, I would like to just highlight two of the most important things, which are also, I would say, important from the security point of view. So automatic provision to MDM. Basically, traditional way is that the IT admin has to send a link or application or some QR code, or there are various possibilities, but anyway, these possibilities somehow needs user interaction. And we had many complaints that users, from IT admins, that the user don't do that or do it in the wrong way, don't read these guides. And at the end of the day, IT admin has some device enrolled to the MDM, and he needs, and some devices not enrolled, so needs to contact these users and find out what happened. So we provide a tool again, which is working at the same concept like in the previous slide. So in the console, you can make MDM profile, and this MDM profile can be not only for our MDM Nox Manage, but also for AirWatch, Mobile Iron, all most of the MDM vendors in the market. And the device, brand new device, once you open the box, the device connects to the internet, and if the to the server, Samsung server, and Samsung server deploys the profile, sends the MDM agent. If you put the credentials, it's even will be automatically registered. So end user does not need to put any login password. It's also possible. And one very nice feature, which was introduced some time ago. For example, we can all the policies in MDM console, we can launch, it could be triggered by some event. So for example, if you are starting a specific application, for example, you're starting your corporate email client, then some policies are starting, so when the higher, let's say, higher security is enabled in the device. Once you disable the application, these policies are disabled back. It can be, we have some events, it can be for certain time, for specific application, when unauthorized SIM is inserted, roaming, and also once you connect to special Wi-Fi. We had one project in for a school, where kids get tablets, And the requirement from the school was that these tablets in the territory of the school must be used only for school applications. So there were like two or three school applications. So the kids cannot launch any Instagram, Facebook games, whatever today kids are using. And we just make a very simple service. So once the device saw Wi-Fi, SSID of the Wi-Fi, the policy was applied. So all the whitelist has been enabled, and only those two or three applications were enabled. All other applications have been blocked. Once the children left the school, then the tablet does not see the Wi-Fi SSID. The policies were disabled, so they can use again games or the other stuff. So we can make a very nice combinations, and it's why it's important from the security point of view. So first of all, people or users, end users, even in employees of our companies, don't want to have too much policies. If they have too much security, they try to bypass it. They try to not to use it. From one of my previous companies, my first business trip with my manager, and he, during the business trip, he was using Gmail for company mails. I asked him why, and he said that, you know, logging to this VPN, giving some OTP codes, doing some strange stuff, it's so complicated that I don't have time for it. And at the end, it often breaks, so it's useless. So that's why we are trying to convince our partners and customers to have as high security as possible, but only for when it's required, not everywhere, because then it's users will stop using that. At the end, I would like to just three things. So use security of our mobile platforms. The security is there. Just let's start to use these things. Keep firmware up to date, very important from security point of view. And separate corporate and private world. So in this corporate world, you can apply really strict security policies, and at the same time, you will keep privacy and usability of the user in the private space. Thank you very much. And we invite you for our booth so we can discuss more. Thank you.